I'm Sarah from The Upcoming. So lovely to speak to you. How are you doing?
Good, thank
very
you
very good,
much.
Thank you. Yes,
maybe you could just kick off. Obviously, we're speaking today about the incredible musical that is The Lion King, with a brief introduction to who you are and the characters that you're playing in the musical.
Yeah. So I'm Melanie McKenzie and I play Shenzi. Gary always laughs when I say that.
Always makes me laugh, that rhyme. I'm Gary Jordan and I play the character of Zazu.
Two amazing characters. In a way, would you say kind of the comic relief? You know, the fantastic characters. It must be a lot of fun to play.
Yes, so much definitely. Fun. So much fun. I love the fact that Zazu is very fussy. He's very sort of very uptight about his job. I love the fact that every so often he's a little bit shady as well. He comes out with some little one-liners that are quite rude. And I love playing him. I really do. He's a fabulous character.
I'm playing Shenzi.
Oh gosh, Shenzi is just so much fun. Like, you know, she's got a little sadistic side to her because, you know, she just takes great pleasure in knowing that she's going to scare these little lion cubs and that they're scared of her. So she quite likes that, but she's also really funny as well. And she's also the leader of the pack. So it's quite nice to lead the two male hyenas and be the big boss lady.
And, you know, The Lion King, one of those stories that I think everyone knows, perhaps originally from, you know, the animation years ago with Disney, but then maybe they've already seen the musical or indeed the latest live action version. But what was it about the story and this musical that made you to particularly want to be involved?
Do you know what it's about? It's a story about family at the heart of it. It's a story about a life and Simba losing his way in life and trying to find where he belongs. And I think that's something that absolutely everybody can relate to across the globe. And I think that's why it really hits a chord with the audiences.
Yeah, I definitely agree. I think there's a lot of themes within the story as well that I feel like a lot of people can relate to, whether it's, you know, love, loss, friendship, fatherhood, brotherhood, sisterhood. There's a lot of you know, I get the pleasure of seeing the audience every night as I come down the aisle, and you really get to see, like, immediately the minute, you know, Rafiki opens with her opening line, the emotion that takes over people. And I think whether you've seen the animated movie or you haven't, it just touches a chord with everybody. And I think it's a story, but also the music as well. Like, the music of the show is so cleverly and beautifully written. Yeah, I think people can take many things from the show, the costume as well. How do they do it? How do they take it from TV to stage? There's just so many things, I think, about the show that people just love, hence why everybody keeps coming back.
And that's the thing, because I think there's lots of movies that they've tried to put on stage and then vice versa, they tried to take things from theatre to film, and it doesn't always work. But there's something about this musical that they've made it into something new, I think, in the translation to stage. So, you know, and what do you think it is that makes it so special and it's had such longevity?
I mean, there's the magic of Julie Taymor's original direction and the mask and the puppet design, and as Mel mentioned, the costumes. And I think, and also I come down the audience in the opening number and I turn around to see over 2,000 people just with their jaws dropped because they cannot believe what they're watching. It's just so extremely clever what Julie Taymor has created. And it suspends your belief. You believe you're watching a stage filled with animals and they're all coming together to celebrate the birth of the new king. And it's quite incredible. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I totally echo what Gary says. Yeah, I totally echo that. I think it's seeing is believing. I think it's one of those you can't quite figure out how do they do it. Even looking at the animals, it's like, how do they replicate a giraffe walking through the pride lands or a zebra? So I think people are astounded, like, this is so clever. And, you know, how does the elephant go down the aisle? Is the people inside it? Is it mechanical? You know, there's all these things. And I think it's that as well. It keeps people kind of like guessing, and like you say, they're in awe of what they're seeing, you know.
And in terms of taking inspiration in the way you play your particular characters, do you think that you have in your mind kind of the voiceovers from the original animation? Were you influenced at all by like the latest live action one? Obviously you had people like Beyonce and Danny Glover heading up that one. Or is it something that you just kind of bring your own version of it to?
I think as an actor, like obviously you can be inspired by other, you know, actors and stuff, but I think what gets you cast in a role as well is what you bring to the character. So as much as, you know, I mean, gosh, I love Whoopi Goldberg and she, you know, she's the voice of Shenzi in the movie. And then Florence Kasumba is Shenzi in the new film. And I'm like, I love Florence Kasumba. So of course I can look at these actresses and think they're amazing. And I look at how they play the role. But I think, yeah, with any actor, it's like, what do you bring to the character? Or what is it within your own personality that the director sees and goes, that's our Zazu or that's our Shenzi. So it's, I think it's what you bring, but of course you, I think even if you can't help it, you must be slightly influenced a little bit, even, you know, but yeah. Yeah, you have to bring yourself to the role, I think, for it to be convincing as well.
Yeah, absolutely. There was a beautiful bit in the reimagined Lion King, the newer film, which actually wasn't in the original animated feature, but it was in the stage show. There's a moment with Zazu and Mufasa, and you find out that Zazu actually looked after Mufasa when he was a child as well. And it's a very sort of heartwarming moment between the two of them. And that was put in for the stage show, but they actually put it in to the latest movie as well, with the brilliant John Oliver, who was Zazu in that one. And I just loved that. I thought, oh, this is gorgeous, because it shows a little bit, apart from his acerbicness, it shows that he's got this really huge heart, and it's very lovely. I mean, I love all the movies and all the spin-offs and The Lion Guard, and I'm a huge fan.
And, you know, how has it felt getting back to the stage after this, I guess it's a year and a half of not being able to perform, audiences not being able to see live performance? You know, what has that feeling been like getting back to the stage?
Oh, it's just been magical, hasn't it? From the moment we stepped back into the rehearsal room, there was this electricity in the air that we all felt. We'd missed it so much. We missed each other. We missed the show. We missed the beautiful building that we work in. And everyone just came together, and just the talent that poured out of everyone, wasn't it, Mal? It was just so incredible to see, because it was something that we'd missed so much. And I think that now has been brought back into our performances, that sort of love of doing it and the love of telling the story that we're telling. And it's really quite electric every single show, isn't it?
It is. And I think, I don't know whether you've seen the video that's gone viral when we all kind of reunited in the rehearsal space. And I've had so many people say to me, like even one of my friends, when she was telling me she watched it, she started crying, telling me that she'd watched the video, because she said, I could feel it in the room, and I wasn't even in the room, you know? And that's what it was for us. I think we'd come out of a pandemic, we'd all been through our own thing, you know, in that year and a half we were away, and coming back together and listening to the songs again, like really listening to the songs, what they mean. A lot of the music took on new meaning. So I think we've all been able to bring a different energy to the show as well, from how we feel now going back. And appreciating that we're able to go back and get back on the stage, whereas there are other shows that haven't been able to do that. So we don't want to take anything for granted. If the pandemic shown us nothing, isn't it? It's like, you can't take anything for granted. So being back on stage in front of audiences every night is just amazing. It really is.
Yeah, and I almost think, obviously no one would ever wish for what we've had to go through, but is there a renewed appreciation for the arts, for live performance? That is actually, you know, quite incredible. I went to a show the other week for the first time in 2 years, and you could just see, like, the reactions weren't just like the normal reactions. Like, everyone was just completely there in the room, and it was quite incredible.
Yeah, that's the thing as well. We're very aware, certainly at this stage, because we're not that far along really since opening, and we're very aware that it is the first time people have stepped into a theatre in 2 years, and you can see it on their faces, can't you, Mo? You can see they're gobsmacked, and finally we get some some, you know, relief from what we've all been through, and we can just lose ourselves in it once again. And so escapism is what everyone's needed, you know.
I mean, it's bonkers, isn't it? Like, because when the show opens, even, you know, we have a new Rafiki playing at the moment, and she said, oh my God, the audience. It's literally, she goes, I wasn't ready for that at all. I wasn't ready, because, you know, she's got to sing in tune and she's got to open with a nah, and the audience is like, I was not ready. I said, girl, this is what it's been like since we've come back. Like, it's as if it's an opening night for us every night, because it's a new audience every night. So for them, it's like, this is the first time they've been to the theatre since, you know, since whenever we were allowed to do this. So it's pretty bonkers. The audience are great.
And I think you've already touched on it a bit, but what do you think it is that people can take away from this story, from this musical? Because there was a bit of everything. It's actually not really a kid's film in some ways. There's some really hard-hitting moments, but there's also lots of like comedy moments. So, you know, what do you think overall people can take away?
I think that's it. It's you will cry, you will laugh, you will sob, you will be totally transported to another world. That escapism is there, and it's what everyone needs. Yep. Yeah.
All right. Well, it's been absolutely fantastic to speak to you both, and best of luck with the next round of performances. I definitely have to come back and see it. I saw it years ago, but I'm going to have to come back because
It's changed since. We've got new bits in there, so definitely come and see it again.
Yeah. 100%. All right. Well, it's lovely to speak to you both. Thank you so much. Thanks.
You too, Sarah. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.